Good evening, Mr.
Good evening.
I'm from Cape Town.
Ashallah.
I'm a truck driver. I'm just driving through.
Right.
And I received this invitation on
local. Lovely.
Now, I'm a Christian. And I would like to ask you one question, that is, why after, since 1948, the 14th of May, when the Jews went back to
Israel,
they became Israel became a nation and all that. I would love to know, since that time they have fought seven wars.
Right.
All seven have been won by the Jews.
Right.
And I would love to know, why is it that that country is surrounded by the Arab states?
160 million Muslims.
Yes. And they ain't able to overpower a country with 140,000 soldiers in the army. Why is that, Mr.?
I'll give you an easy answer. Sit down. Sit down, dears. You know, Smith in southern Rhodesia, he declared the UDI, Unilateral Declaration of Independence. You remember that? For 12 years, he made the whole of Africa to say, hey, you bloody rubbish, stand afar, don't come near. And there were only 250,000. Do you know that? Did you know that there are only 250,000 whites in southern Rhodesia, and they had the whole of Africa, your Nigeria and your Ghana and your Malawi and whole bang lot of us, keep at arm's length, your bloody rubbish. For 12 years, he kept us there. No, he's the armory, weapons. That guy has got the weaponry. America is behind him. Every time the Muslim goes to war against the Jew, he's not fighting the Jew, he's fighting America. In 1973, for the first time, the Arabs took the initiative. The Ramadan War, the October War, Sadat crossed the Bar-Lev line, he had the Jews by the throat. And the Jews cried for help. And Reagan rushed into the battle with his men and machines through the Azores, direct into the battlefield. So we are not fighting the Jews. This is Jewish facade, it's a front. We are actually fighting America. Inshallah, say God willing, one day, things will come right. They're working, today little children are facing them with stones. That spirit will win. This is what God wants. The spirit is the spirit that's going to win. The guy's giving in. His own says, all right, now, man, you have a little peace here, a little peace there. His nation says, no. But he still says, no, he knows which side his bread is buttered. So he says, now leave it to God. God in his wisdom, he's got his plan. Is a purification for us. We need purification. You see, we are not altogether pure. We have to be purified. In our intentions and our spirit, we have to be purified to get victory. It'll take time, but inshallah it's working. It'll work. Like it happened here in Rhodesia. They got the independence. But for 12 years, Smith, with his 250,000, he had the whole of Africa. How many? 200 million Africans at bay. Or 300 million Africans. Say, you bloody rubbish, keep out. Keep out of my country. And 250,000 at that. So it is the armaments, the weapon, that did the job. Same thing here. 300 years, the guy ruled us. 300 years. What did it? Is he more than you? No. Is he stronger than you? No. No, it's a weapon. He had the arms. So, fortunately, thank God, the Russians said, well, we'll help the ANC, and Libya says, we'll help you, and so on says, we'll help you, China says, we'll help you, and over a period of time, we got independence with all this help. One day, inshallah, the Middle East will also come right. Any other questions?